Capella, Deke Sharon here. I'm sorry I can't be with you in person in Omaha. I would love to, but COVID, etc., etc. So, coming to you from my home in San Francisco, and hopefully you are all still safe and will remain so until we get the vaccine and we can be together next year. So, I really enjoyed listening to your performance of Count on Me. Like I said, I wish I were there in person. I could hear all the rich overtones swinging through the room, but computer laptop speakers are going to have to suffice. And by the way, the video is right down there, so if I ever like look down here or make comments down there, I'm not looking at a houseplant. It's your video. So the first thing I'd say about your video is that it's charming and it's warm, but it's a little loose. It's a little out of tune early on. And I think part of the issue is that you guys don't get off on the right foot. So I hear in the very first notes of the melody, it's like there are three or four different keys kind of happening. Now, once you get back together, once you all kind of lock in and you get to the chorus, there's a strength there and a unification of sound. But before that, it's a little uneven. And I wish maybe, I'm sure if you do it again, and certainly by the end of the school year, it'll end up being a lot more locked in together. So I don't want to put too fine a point on it. But it's really important, like everybody starts right here. And be careful not to, up the octave, right? But be careful not to like swoop too much into the early notes of the song. Like you really want to kind of, it's like, you know, gymnastics, you stick the landing. For this, you want to stick the beginning. You want to be like, da 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 da, like da 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 da. If it's too swoopy, then it's hard for everybody to kind of get locked together. And then once you're locked together, it's easier to pull everything together. Another thing I'm noticing is that the tone, particularly up in the melody, is it's got a nasalness to it and not as much richness and warmth. And that might also be making it a little harder to tune. There's, if you're using, quote unquote, your whole instrument, if you're resonating all the way through your head, there's a warmth and a brightness to the sound. There are more overtones getting sent out there. And I realize this might be the artifact of the microphone that captured the overall sound, but I think some of it's in the vocal production as well, right? And the song is kind of cutesy, so it kind of wants a little bit of like a sing-songy quality to it. And I'm not saying you need to get classical and low and full with your voice. But there is a way to sing instead of like it, you'll engage more of your resonance, which will really make a difference in the overall richness of the sound. Okay, let's see, a couple other things. Listening. Something I'm noticing is that your rhythm is actually extremely good, and often with groups like this, particularly when you spread out in one line, you'd be more shaky, right? And yet you guys all lock together, so you really have a good rhythmic sense. And in fact, some of you are just kind of swaying back and forth, which sometimes can push you in the other direction, make it even harder. And I'd be all ready to give you like all these comments about what you can do to keep that locked in. But your internal metronomes are excellent. Even the people on the outsides, like you're spread wide, but you're locking the rhythm of your unisons. Your timing is excellent. So it's really a matter of getting the tuning snapped together. And now people may tell you that tuning is the most important part of it, but it's not. It's the rhythm. Everybody can tell if something's out of rhythm, right? We are all used to like clocks ticking and metronomes in our heads, and we walk in rhythm. And so the sense of a steady pace, the sense of a groove, is absolutely inherent to what we're doing. I'm not saying the tuning doesn't matter. I'm just saying that it's actually not the most important thing, and you guys have that nailed. Let's see one more little bit here. Yeah, when you get up to those high note sopranos, your instinct is to, you're kind of like, do, you're kind of closing it off. Da-da-da. You have to open and widen the vowel. This is what operatic singers do. This is what pop singers generally do. If you open everything up, you're going to have much more tone, and you'll find it much easier to get up to those high notes rather than kind of closing off as you get up there. And my last little comment would be for the background parts. Your vowels are kind of moving towards a schwa. Like instead of do, they're going to do, right? They're kind of going towards a kind of a sound, right? Which sounds like you're not interested. Sounds like you're not engaged, right? Do. Sounds like, dude, I don't really care what's going on, right? As opposed to do. And the song is You Can Count on Me, right? It's not like, well, if I get around to it, I'll help you out, right? So what you really want to do is you want to be on top of the sound. You want to send the subliminal message in the backgrounds that reinforces the overall message of the song, if that makes any sense. That makes some sense, right? And you can tell from someone's vowel sound how they're feeling, right? When you pick up the phone and you talk to somebody, you know, call somebody and they go like, hello, you can tell that they're not in the same mood as if they go, hello, right? Just the simple change of vowel from a smile can make a difference. So especially by the last chorus of that song, you want to make sure that you're still engaged, you're not going into autopilot, and that you're really on do, as opposed to do, which will help with tuning as well. It'll help with casting more overtones and making everything easier to lock. Anyway, I hope this was helpful, and I hope we are together in person at Midland next year. Until then, please stay safe and keep singing and have a good time, and I'll hopefully see you then.